Hello, this is Bern, and if you've been struggling to attract a conscious, intelligent, confident man into your life, and you've been secretly telling yourself that there's too much competition out there, well, you are in luck, because on today's episode, I'm going to share with you from head to toes how to be the woman awesome men crave without having to change the core of who you are. Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered women how you can attract the relationship and the man you crave without the need for manipulation, gimmicks, or stupid techniques. Now, the topic of this video is somewhat triggering for some women. I understand why, because how to be the woman awesome men crave presupposes you're doing something for men. And I want to first start by saying, this is not something you're doing for men, it's something you're doing for yourself. It just so happens that when you do it this way, men also find you way more attractive, and you cross the barrier between a man saying, she's interesting, to I have to connect with her, or from I have to connect with her to I have to see her again. So the first concept I want to introduce to you is the way to become the woman awesome men crave is to become the woman you are mostly inspired by. To live the kind of life that you say, wow, I'm in love with this life, and if somebody gets to join me, then even better, right? But if somebody doesn't get to join me, my life is awesome. So it's 1 + 1 = 10 versus 1 + 1 = 1, which is the way some people look at this. So I'm gonna give you some concepts that are important to work on so that you can enhance your attractive and magnetism factor by exponential numbers, while also feeling more excited about your own life. The first one is your own acceptance and self-love. So what does that mean? That means that there is nothing sexier in a woman that a woman who's aware of what she has to offer and is at peace and at ease with her heart, her body, her curves, or lack thereof, and is showing up unapologetically, not feeling more than, but not feeling less than anyone else. So when that human being, that woman shows up and she's comfortable and excited about what she has to offer, men find her way more irresistible. So what's the call to action here? There's gonna be areas of your life where you feel very confident. Maybe you like your eyes, but you don't like your toes. Maybe you like your legs, but you don't like your ass. Maybe you like your torso, but you don't like your stomach. This is the chance for you to say, fuck it. I'm going to love myself as I am right now, and I'm gonna show that into the world. And if a guy doesn't like it, that's his deal. I love and accept myself because the combination of who I am is unique, irreplaceable, and very exciting for the right person. So that's the attitude that you come with. And how do you do that? One step at a time, one body part at a time, one day at a time, one degree at a time, but you do it until you feel at peace with what you have to offer. Number two, radiance, working on your radiance. Why is radiance so important? Because radiance is like the sun. Think about the sun. Think about what the sun brings to the universe, right? To our solar system, to our earth. Without the sun, we could not leave. We flock towards the light. So men flock towards the light. And what is that light? The light that you emanate without having to utter a word. When you enter a room, a woman with radiance naturally is attractive. And what do you have to do to work on your radiance? Well, simple. Work on what makes your heart sing. Work on doing the things that make you feel fulfilled, excited, contributing, at peace. The things that make you shine, things that make you vibrate at a higher level, from anything from feeling grateful to dancing to singing to anything that enhances your feeling of vibration, that is something that men find incredibly attractive. You can't point it down. You just find yourself saying, wow, there's something to that woman. So as you grow your radiance, guess what happens? Your life gets better automatically. Your life gets more exciting automatically, and you feel able to express more of who you are. Third, clarity of thought. Why is this so important? Because there's so many women out there who, out of fear of being ridiculed, of being judged, of having men be turned off by them, don't either take the time to know what they want or express it, which will be another step. But let's talk about clarity of thought. What do you want? What do you love? What do you hate? What's life about? What are your values? What are your rules for those values? The clearer you are on who you are and what you want, the more specifically you can figure out what it is that makes you feel at peace in a partner. the less you have that clarity of thought, including important subjects like, do you want children? Do you want to get married? When do you want to get married? All those things are important to figure out because they're going to enhance, not limit, enhance your capacity to get what you want. When you're a generalist, when you want everything, that's okay. Well, a relationship. Well, what's a relationship that you want? Well, something deep. What does something deep mean? Go deeper and deeper until you have clarity as to what you want. That can turn off the wrong types of men from connecting with you. Number four, area to work on is expressiveness. So the difference, the expressiveness, the way I'm defining it here, is the difference between mumbling and singing. Mumbling is, I have something and I'm just gonna faintly put it out in the world to not having inside. Singing is, this is the song of me and I want to shout it to the four winds. Why? Because, not because I feel the world needs to hear it, but because not doing so kills me inside. So expressiveness, same thing. What are the things that make you unique and how do you want to bring them out to the world? Do you like singing? Do you like writing? Do you like move and dance? Do you have specific thoughts on different areas? Like being willing to express that. What else? Being able to express, step number five, standards and boundaries, right? When you're able to express more of who you are, then the next step, which is expressing and clearly defining standards and boundaries, becomes easier. So standards are, what do you want in terms of respect, in terms of physical touch, in terms of dating, in terms of timeline, in terms of attraction, in terms of quality of communication, what do you want in a relationship? What do you want to experience? What's the baseline minimum thing you must experience in order to make this work? And the counterpart to that is boundaries, because when you have standards, then you're able to express boundaries. The guy wants to have sex with you the first date. Well, guess what? I don't have sex on first dates. Why? Because I haven't met the guy for long enough to understand if that's something that will, it just doesn't sound, it doesn't resonate with me. I have sex when, and then you set your boundary, when we're exclusive, when we're boyfriend, girlfriend, and it's gonna take some time for that. In the meantime, I wanna get to know you and I wanna get to understand who you are and I wanna make sure that we're compatible so that when that connection takes place, and we maybe get attached more than we would if we didn't have sex, then that we're getting attached for the right reasons instead of just for chemical reasons that will wake up one day not knowing where's up and where's down, but feeling really depleted of energy and happiness. So working on your standard, defining what they are, and expressing boundaries. Again, this is one of the most misunderstood areas about dating and connecting with men. Many women think that if you have high standards, and you're able to express boundaries with clarity, that men will run away. The only men who will run away are the men who are not willing to uphold those standards, the guys who are not respectful of those boundaries, which by definition means they're not your guy. Now, unless your boundary is something extremely crazy, guys should be willing to put the energy forward and work through those boundaries, right? So that's step number five. Step number six, developing the artistic way of making the move that will make him move. Another big area of misconception. Many women think, well, if I'm a radiant goddess, if I have everything worked out, if I have standards and boundaries, expressiveness, clarity of thought, if I'm radiating more light than usual, if I self-accept my body and I show up with that type of energy, then, well, it's just a done deal. No, it's not a done deal. The last step is crucial, which is make the move that will make him move. Make the move means looking into his eyes instead of looking away. Make the move means smiling instead of frowning. And you don't, even if you're wearing a mask, you can smile and your eyes will shine through that smile. Making the move means being willing to ask a question. Making the move means willing to start a conversation. Now, when you do that move, that is the move that's going to allow him to see that you're not gonna punch him in the nuts if he approaches you, that you're not gonna reject him, that you're not gonna say, well, it's not gonna be super awkward for him. Now, when you do that first move, which is something simple, then he can either step up and connect and do the rest or pass. And if he passes, then guess what? You are the woman who's putting life into your own hands. You're taking action and you're not begging, you're not pursuing, you're simply stepping into dropping a handkerchief where the right guy can pick it up and flow with that. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful to you. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do one thing. On the first link on the description of this video, you're gonna find a masterclass that I created that will show you how you can enter the relationship you want with a lot less speed and less pain. If you like this video, click like and thumbs up. and subscribe to my channel so you can be notified of new episodes as they come out. Last but not least, if you're a woman who's watching this video, you've been at this game, and I say game in the kind word of connecting with men and going on dating and online dating and reading books and practicing the law of attraction and doing a bunch of things, including watching videos, and you're not getting what you want, you might need more than what you're doing to get it. And if you ever want to find out if you and I can work together, I can hold you by the hand through this process, on the second link on the description of this video, you'll find a way to apply and figure out if we're a good fit to work together so I can help you personally. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.